This video is sponsored by us. Lifespan.io, the charity that powers LifeNoggin, is hosting the most exciting science event of the year, Ending Age-Related Diseases 2023. If you love science, you won't want to miss this. Stay tuned to learn more. Hey there. Welcome to LifeNoggin. With the Barbie and Oppenheimer movies releasing on the same day, I've seen so many split memes because of both of these movies' contrasting aesthetics. Triangle Bob is a huge fan of both of these movies, hence why his room looks like this. I've asked him to give me some questions related to those movies, so let's see what kind of fun questions he's come up with. How long would my Barbie take to decompose? That's a good question, though a little dark. Grieg, do not throw that Barbie on the Barbie. I see the humor there, but that's very dangerous. The materials used to make Barbie have changed over the years, but today's dolls are made from a variety of hard-to-pronounce plastics. These include a compound vinyl head, EVA arms, an ABS torso, and PVC legs. While there have been some dolls made out of recycled plastic, the vast majority are made from virgin or newly manufactured plastic. This is bad news for the environment. Plastic waste makes up 80% of ocean debris, and of all the plastic that gets thrown away, only a small percentage, about 4.5%, is recycled. The majority, about 18.5%, gets stuck in landfills. This is because plastic is really hard to recycle and nearly impossible to decompose. Some of Barbie's materials, like her polypropylene and PVC legs, will take up to 450 years to degrade. And her ABS torso is the strongest plastic out there. It could take at least 500 years to degrade just a little. Hopefully, Mattel can reach its goal of using 100% recycled or recyclable material by 2030. Oh, I almost forgot. I have the most exciting news. Lifespan.io, the charity that powers LifeNoggin, is hosting their very own science conference on August 10th and 11th in New York City. It's going to be extremely fun. Learn about scientific breakthroughs with potential to reshape the world. No biggie. They'll be discussing everything from the fundamentals of aging to revolutionary new ways of funding research and even how AI is transforming research as we know it. Want in on the action but can't make it in person? You can also watch all the talks online. Check out the first link in the description right now and grab yourself a ticket before they're all gone. All of the proceeds go to charity, so it's the perfect opportunity to do something good for the world, support our channel, and learn mind-blowing science at the same time. It's a win-win-win. Use the code KEEPONTHINKING to get a 20% discount on your ticket. Okay, what else are you wondering about? Let's see. What if you stood right next to an atomic bomb? Oh, great, another fun one. Triangle Bob, I'm loving your thirst for knowledge, but the FBI might be diving a bit deeper into your search history right now. Atomic bombs use a process called fission to create a massive explosion. This is when atoms split apart into two or more smaller atoms. To make this happen, Oppenheimer's bomb used TNT to compress plutonium so densely that it made its atoms bump into each other and break down, resulting in an incredibly powerful explosion. When tested in 1945, the blast was equal to 21 kilotons of TNT. So, what would that be like for a person standing nearby? Well, as soon as the bomb explodes, everyone within 100 feet would instantly vaporize into a spray of atoms. All that would remain is their silhouettes on nearby surfaces. Has anyone seen Ken? He was just standing here a minute ago. Oh no. So, did you enjoy this episode? Triangle Bob, did you already move on to Willy Wonka? Okay, save those candy-coated questions for another video. In the meantime, tell me your favorite movie down below. Should I make a science-y video on it? Answer away. Click here to watch this video we did on, I forgot. Something about memory? Or click here to watch this video. As always, my name is Blocko. This has been LifeNoggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.